In the 1970s, there were few tight ends in football better than Riley Odoms. After being drafted 5th overall in the 1972 NFL Draft, he stepped onto the scene and was a force to be reckoned with. He made it to 4 Pro Bowls, including 3 straight from 1973 to 75, was named a first-team All-Pro in 1974 and 75, and was named a second-team All-Pro during the 1977 season, when he helped the Broncos reach their first Super Bowl in franchise history. As a side note, if you want to learn more about that game, click the link in the upper right corner. And yet, despite his 12-year career in Denver, his name is largely forgotten. He's not in the Hall of Fame, nor should he be. His number isn't retired. There are no highlight videos of him. He's not in the Ring of Fame for the Broncos, and his greatness as a tight end was overshadowed a decade later by Shannon Sharp. And unfortunately, a big reason why might have to do with his rather unceremonious exit. This is the story of the downfall of one of the most underrated tight ends in football history. Dan Reeves became the head coach of the Broncos in 1980, which was right when Odoms entered his 30s. And in those first 2 seasons under Reeves, Odoms' numbers were pretty good. They were right in line with the rest of his career, and the similarities between the 1980 and 81 season were uncanny. He put up almost identical numbers in those first 2 seasons with Reeves, and was showing no signs of slowing down entering the 1982 season. But in 1982, a strike loomed in the distance, and Odoms was not in good shape at all. Odoms usually played somewhere around 230 pounds. When he showed up to training camp in 1982, he was 260. For some perspective, at that point in NFL history and AFL history, I could only find 3 tight ends who had ever played at that weight or higher. One of them was Dave Lintz of the Eagles, who never caught a single pass in the NFL. And the other 2 were Ronnie Lee of the Dolphins and Paul Costa of the Bills, both of whom would eventually convert to the offensive line. And keep in mind that the 260 pounds listed was after training camp, when he tried shedding weight, so he probably showed up to camp somewhere in the 270 range. Odoms showed up to training camp significantly out of shape, and it showed. He had a disastrous season, which was undoubtedly the worst of his career. In 8 games, he had 8 receptions for 82 yards and no touchdowns. Even if you extrapolate those numbers to a full 16-game season because of the strike, they're still atrocious, and it still results in career lows in every single category for his career. Catches, yards, yards per catch, touchdowns, any way you want to slice it, he was awful. The 1983 season was a chance for Odoms to right the ship and show that he still had something left in the tank. The 33-year-old was told that to even have a shot at making the team, he had to trim down to at least 240 pounds. He couldn't stay at the playing weight he was at in 1982. Odoms got there, and so the competition was on between him and James Wright for the starting job. Reeves didn't want to keep Odoms around as a backup, so he made his message simple. If he can't win the starting job, he's going to be cut. And when Reeves announced this to a local television show, Odoms decided to quit. He was upset at Reeves for announcing this on television, thinking that the conversation was between just the 2 of them, and he felt that throughout training camp and the earlier preseason games, he had not been given an opportunity to win the job. He said, "I felt the decision had already been made, and I had little chance of making it. Only a blind man would have not seen the fact that they were phasing me out, not throwing the ball to me. It's been killing me to death, and that's not right. As far as I'm concerned, I'm unemployed." After Odoms left practice, abruptly quit, and lashed out at the media, he returned the very next day, pulling a George Costanza well before George Costanza was even a thing. And unsurprisingly, Odoms didn't win the job. James Wright was named the starter at tight end, and Odoms was released. The story isn't done just yet, as 2 months later, Odoms re-signed with the Broncos, but got placed on injured reserve after 1 game against the Bengals. He came off IR later in the season, but didn't do a whole lot, and was done playing after the 1983 campaign. It's unfortunate and bizarre how Odoms' career ended in Denver, and how nowadays, he is a seemingly forgotten player from the 70s. And whether you side with Reeves or Odoms on this issue, it didn't have to be this way. It's a shame how Odoms is more remembered for how his career ended than for how great his decade-long career was, where he was one of the best tight ends that played the game. Special thanks to all of our Patreon supporters for helping on the channel. Your support is greatly appreciated. See how you can become a patron and request future video topics in the description below.